All right, welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. And joining me now is Shawn Khunkhun. He is the CEO of Dolly Varden Silver. And Shawn, it's good to see you. How are you?
I am doing excellent here a few days before Christmas. It's been a big year at 2023. Looking forward to 2024. Happy to be on.
Good stuff. Well, excited to have you here. There's lots to talk about. Just before we get into some recent news that you had, maybe just give me sort of a bit of an overview of the company itself.
Yes. So Dolly Varden is very unique. Look, there's not a lot of primary silver mines in the world, and there's even fewer in safe, stable jurisdictions. So we've got a project that's up in Northwest BC. We're in the Golden Triangle, one of the richest precious metals camps on the planet. The project goes back 100 years. What we've done is we've brought in a new team. We've brought in a lot of money. We've done consolidation. We've done drilling. So what we've outlined is a high-grade precious metals endowment. There was some resource estimates that were done in 2019 that outline about 63, 64 million ounces of silver and 1 million ounces of gold. So if we express that in a silver equivalent, it's about 140 million ounces of silver EQ in all categories. Extremely high grade, over 300 gram per ton silver. And then we've done about 100,000 meters of drilling. And that 100,000 meters of drilling does not reflect the 140 million ounces we have. We've got investors like Hecla Mining, you know, the fastest growing established silver producer on the planet, is a 15% shareholder and recently increased their stake in their company from 10% to 15% with a $10 million direct investment, which I think is an incredible validation of the project. We've also got Eric Sprott, institutions like Fidelity, and institutional shareholders make up about 50% of our register. So it's a great company. It's got grade, it's got size, and it's in a safe location.
So you mentioned all the work that's been done on it so far. So what point are you at now?
Well, I believe in the stock market, it's all about growth. Mm-hmm. So we are adding ounces. And, you know, if you're a producer, you want to grow your production profile. If you're an explorer, you want to increase your mineral and inventory, and that's how you get valued. So what point we're at is we're at a point of continuing to expand and grow high-grade resources. And, you know, as the miners mine and they deplete their mineral inventory, in order to replace those ounces, they're going to need to be acquisitive. Right. And it's the reason that when I took over this company a few years ago, we were a $20 million company. We are now a $250 million company. But we see the value here for the potential of a billion dollar company.
Okay. I know that you had some news out recently, and that is you've done an agreement with Libero Copper. Can you talk a bit about what this does? And in essence, you mentioned earlier consolidating, correct?
Yeah, look, I take my time. I monitor a number of things. The big bulk acquisition has been something that I've been trying to do for 4 years. And I've just been waiting and waiting and waiting and waiting. And other companies have come and gone, and they've invested a lot of money. And what we did is we did a phenomenal deal for our shareholders by issuing about $200,000 in stock. We got an option assigned. And now we have 100% interest in the big bulk porphyry, which is potentially the feeder to all of the high-grade gold and silver mineralization at Dolly Varden. You know, speculators will be aware of a discovery story in Idaho called Hercules, symbol big. And it's an example of what porphyries can deliver. And we've got a porphyry here that we know is fertile, that has produced some incredible grades. And there has been some analogies comparing our porphyry to KSM, which is the largest undeveloped gold project on the planet. So we've got a copper gold porphyry, but our focus has been the high grade gold and silver, and it's going to continue to be our focus. But when I took over Dolly Varden a few years ago, we were drilling very modest programs, 6,000-7,000 meters. We just completed a 51,000 meter program. So now I have the budget. I drilled 115 holes this year. We could take a few of those holes and put them into the porphyry, and giving our shareholders the upside opportunity of a underexplored big copper gold porphyry. But again, the focus, 95, 96, 97% of the focus is going to remain on the low hanging fruit, which we've done a phenomenal job of expanding and extending.
Okay, let's talk about next year, 2024. You mentioned the company is obviously in a very good position right now. So let everyone know what's going to happen in 2024, your plan.
Well, look, we're going to continue. Like, if it's not broken, don't fix it. We've had phenomenal results we put out recently where we're drilling, 30 meters of high grade silver, expanding and extending known zones. I've got 70 drill holes that I'm set to report in the new year. So once we report those holes, and what we're trying to do there, Steve, is we've got a number of deposits on the property. Some are past producing. We want to show that they're not individual deposits, that they may be related. We're trying to connect deposits. If we can do that, I think it's the watershed moment for Dolly Varden. We're already at a point where, we've got some size, we've got some grade. I think the next round of drilling has the potential to be that watershed moment. And then on the back of that, I know exactly what I want to do in 2024. And it's more of the same. It is going out and continuing to delineate resources in between deposits, expanding and extending. And the question that I'm setting out to answer is this a 1 billion ounce silver camp? We're 14% of the way there as of 2019. We've done 100,000 meters of drilling. Let's see where those results take us. But can it be SK? Can it be Brucejack? Can it be Premier? Those world famous mines are just north of us, set in the same mineralizing event, same age, and same features. And we've got the team, we've got the money, and we've got the shareholders to answer those unanswered questions.
All right. Sounds like it's going to be a pretty exciting 2024 for sure. Shawn, thanks so much. Good to catch up with you and see where you're at. And we look forward to continuing to follow the story. Okay.
Thank you so much. Thanks for having me on. Merry Christmas.
All right. Merry Christmas to you as well. Shawn Khunkhun, the CEO of Dolly Varden Silver.